Hello, welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Dilly, and we're gonna be looking at the game against Spurs and Ajax as they look to battle into the Champions League semi-final, the first leg. I'm really a neutral in this one, so I'm not really quite sure how this one is gonna play out, but my money, I'll put it on Ajax with the way they performed until this point. Hopefully that continues. I would love to see Ajax in the final, to be honest. Spurs can sit this one out for 1 year, maybe try again some other time. But Ajax, for me, have been the most impressive team that I have seen in terms of, like, you say, like, the underdogs going into this one. Even Spurs as well, they're in the same position. But for Spurs, they've been battling everything for the last 4 years or so. So for me, I would like to see more Ajax into the final. Possibly, I don't know. Possibly, I would say against Barcelona, because on the other hand, I don't really want Liverpool to win the damn thing. So I'll be looking forward to that game as well, Barcelona and Liverpool. But right now, I'd like to take a look at the matches that were played between Ajax, starting from the group stage, really, and just run it down real quick and see how the hell did Ajax find themselves in this position right now. So let's just take a look at that. And this is the group stages, of course. I'm just going to go through here, look at Spurs, and then I'll look at how Ajax finished. I think the both teams finished in second place in the group stages. As you can see, Tottenham came second to Barcelona there. They could potentially meet again in the final if Spurs do go through to the final. Spurs only finished off with 8 points, but they did have a greater goal difference on that, -1, but they scored more goals than Inter Milan, so that will send them through to the round of 16. And of course, Barcelona going through on that. Let's see here where Ajax finished second to Bayern Munich. Bayern Munich had been knocked out a long time ago from the Champions League. As you can see here, Ajax finishing off with 12 points, only 2 points shy of Bayern Munich of winning the group there. I think pretty much an impressive performance by Ajax. As you can see here, 3 wins and 3 draws, no losses in the group stages, scoring 11 goals, allowing only 5, with finishing off the group stages with a 6+ goal difference on that. Bayern Munich, you know, they did their thing, scoring 15 goals in the process in the group stages. I think that's pretty good. Now let's just go through here and see from the round of 16, the first leg. Ajax lost to Real Madrid there by 2-1. Let's see Tottenham here. Tottenham won by 3-0 against Borussia Dortmund. I think Tottenham really took this tie in the first leg, really, by winning those 3-0. Ajax had to work a little bit harder in the second leg to go through to the quarterfinals. As you can see here, absolutely dominant in this game, Ajax. I was very much impressed with the way they were playing. I did not expect that. I thought Real Madrid are gonna just cruise through to the quarterfinals of the Champions League, but Ajax, oh my lord, Ajax just could not stop performing. They just could not stop performing, scoring 4 goals in the process. Let's see here what the hell happened. Who got a red card here for? Was it Nacho in the dying minutes of the game, getting himself a red card there? As you can see, Real Madrid had 58% ball possession. Ajax really trying their very best to dominate the game, but coming up with only 42% ball possession on that. Let's look at Tottenham here real quick. Of course, they already knew they just needed probably 1 goal or 2 just to make sure they put away Borussia Dortmund here as they do get themselves one goal. Harry Kane in the 48th minute. In terms of possession, once again, Spurs being dominated by Borussia Dortmund, but you understand how that could come out to be. I'm pretty sure Dortmund were playing to try and push back those three goals that they conceded in the first leg. But that didn't work at all as Tottenham win on aggregate 4-0. And then we're going to look at the quarterfinals of the two teams here. Tottenham had to play Manchester City. I was on Team Tottenham on this one. Very much looking forward for Tottenham to go through to the semifinals. Yeah, so I was very, very impressed to trying to stop Manchester City to try and get that quadruple. Ajax were like, it's not going to happen on my watch, son. And then you look at the Ajax game against Juventus there in the first leg, coming up 1-1. I think, let me just look at that real quick. 61% ball possession in the first leg compared to only 39 for Juventus. As you can see here, this is when really Ajax started really, I think like from the second leg of the round of 16, they really started pushing big teams back, really trying to put, but like really starting to play there. As you can see, 61% ball possession to 31. I think that's pretty impressive for a team like Ajax. You can't really take them lightly because I think Ajax are a good team, just coming up with the big dogs, as you can say. But as you will say, but other than that, I think Ajax performed very, very well. And then you look at the second leg of this one, Ajax having to win by 2-1, playing away to Juventus, but they absolutely dominated the game. For me, I think this 51% and 49% really doesn't make too much of a difference. I think Ajax had this game in the bag. Everybody really performing in the Ajax game. I think the second half of this one was very much impressive from Ajax. Juventus really didn't have a say in this game, I would like to say. And now the two teams find themselves into the semi-final of the Champions League here. As you can see, the first leg is going to kick out very, very soon. I can't wait for the game. I'm going to be a neutral on this one once again, but I would love to see Ajax really put on a performance and try to go through to the Champions League final. And then, of course, next tomorrow is going to be Barcelona and Liverpool. That could be a very much tasty game as well. I don't know who's going to win that, but my money is on Barcelona on this one. I really don't want Liverpool to win the Champions League either. For me, the final should be Ajax and Barcelona, just because I don't want Spurs to win it, and on the other side, I don't want Liverpool to win it. Well, that's my opinion, so you guys can let me know in the comment section what you think about that. I think this one is going to be a cracking game. Hopefully, it's going to be live up to the expectations, really. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm looking forward to the game. This guy, Dejong, this is Frankie Dejong. I think this guy is going to be pulling up the strings for Ajax in the middle of the park here to really try to put Spurs through the sword. So I'm going to be looking out for this game. Hopefully, it's going to live up to the expectations. I am so excited. Even tomorrow as well, it's going to be a massive, massive game for both teams. I think from here on, these teams are just not going to be putting out, just trying to go through. They're going to be putting out performances, and of course, they're going to have strategies on how they want to accomplish that to find themselves into the final of the Champions League. Make sure you do subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. I'm out.